monster. No. She did suddenly become a monster. Yes. That's your fault. What you did and what you did not do. Mm. By commission and by omission. Yes. Mm-hmm. Okay? So when the child arrived at your doorstep, in your family, he or she was blank. Yes. Was a blank disc. And this is how we filled those discs. When we criticize them, they learn to condemn. When we're hostile towards them, they learn to fight. When we ridicule them, they learn to be shy. When we, if the child is with jealousy, he feels guilty. When they live with impropriety, he learns to feel shame. If a child is with intolerance, he learns to be patient, and intolerance, vice versa. Now, unfortunately for us, there's a lot of history that informs the way we behave, the way we behave. We are in a place where a number of us are still trying to catch up. We're in a place where we're struggling. We're not on top of things. We're overstretched, and consequently, inevitably, we will be snappy. Because we work so hard, inevitably, we will be on the edge. So if we have a consciousness that what we infuse in our children is what affects them later, I believe strongly that it helps a great deal, because it's something that I have tried and I have tested. So living day to day, recognizing that our children end up being intolerant and condemned and feeling guilty and feeling that impropriety is as a result of what we impute in them, I think it helps. If a child needs encouragement, he learns.